everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about solids, liquids, and gases. One thing which is common between solids, liquids, and gases are particles. Imagine particles as small balls which are always moving. These particles behave differently in solids, liquids, and gases. Let's talk about solids first. Some examples of solids are ice cubes, an apple, and a car. What is common in all these solids? The particles and solids are very close together and arranged in a regular pattern. They are also held together by strong forces. And finally, they cannot move from place to place. Now, we'll talk about liquids. Some examples of liquids are juice, milk, and water. The particles in liquids are not as close together as in solids. They are arranged in a random way, and they are not held as tightly together as in solids, thus enabling them to move freely. Lastly, we'll talk about gases. Some examples of gases are air, oxygen, and gases coming out of a car. The particles of gas are not close together. They're arranged in a random way, and forces between the particles are tiny, and therefore they can move freely wherever they want. So, in a nutshell, solids like wood are hard because the particles are arranged in a regular pattern. They are close together, and the forces between the particles are very strong. Liquids like water can flow because the particles are arranged randomly. They are not as close as in solids, and the forces between the particles are not as strong as in solids. Therefore, it allows them to flow. And finally, gases like oxygen can move freely because the particles are arranged randomly. They are very far apart and the forces between the particles are very weak. Therefore, they can spread freely. Thank you for listening. I hope it was useful.